It's been 3 years since the city started testing high-tech parking meters, but we've learned it may have been a costly mistake. The smart meters are solar-powered and can accept credit and debit cards. Hundreds have been installed, but problems are prompting the city to have second thoughts about them. Brent Romadna has been digging deeper into the issues. Brent?
Geoofficials tell me that the cost to fix some of the problems with the smart meters is eating away at the revenue the city takes in. It's now forced the city to look over the entire program. It's a common problem. You need to park somewhere with a parking meter, but you can't find the coins. That's one reason the city added smart parking meters.
I think it was a good choice that they have the options to have both payments or coins or credit cards.
But while the high-tech meters are convenient, they're also causing some problems.
So we installed 340 smart meters in the Chinatown District, Financial District, and Civic Center. And since we installed them, we've had some challenges.
The city started installing these smart meters in 2012 at a cost of $350,000. But 1 year into the project, they started noticing some problems.
I can't see the time. Like, I can't even see when this expires. I had to ask another guy, could he see what time my meter expired?
Rochelle Kim uses the smart meters quite a bit and has had her fair share of complications.
I moved because the other one wouldn't take my card at all. It wouldn't turn on and it wouldn't press any of the buttons.
The city says they've had problems with the solar panels on the meters, batteries draining too quickly, and in some cases people would put in coins and the machine would not show credit.
What do you tell taxpayers right now that may have concerns that they weren't working?
Actually, they worked really well, but they didn't do everything that they were represented to do. So it's whether or not you're getting your value for your money.
So how will the city do that? Two options are to go with different smart meters or go with a multi-stall meter, like the ones we see at the zoo. But the main goal is to get something that works and doesn't cause problems.
I want my staff just to make sure that before we make the decision to move forward, whatever that technology is, it's the best and in the interest of the taxpayers.
The city tells me they are working with the manufacturer on a weekly basis to try to address the problems. I was also told the other cities are using the same meters and are also dealing with similar problems. We'll be following up and let you know what the city plans to do next. Brent Romadna, KHON 2 News.